Let's take a case study under direct redistribution method. We have X Limited with 3 production department and 4 service departments. The expenses for these departments as per primary distribution summary are as follows. Production department ABC, these are all the values. Service department are basically stores, timekeeping and accounts, power, canteen, respective amounts, and we have the total. The following information is also available in respect of production departments. So we have 3 production department, that is ABC. So this is the information. Horsepower of machine, department A 300, B 300, C 200. Number of workers 20, 15, 15. Value of stores requisition 2,50,000, 1,50,000, 1,00,000. You have to apportion the cost of service department over production department. So here, if you look at the cost of service department, their cost is with regard to stores, timekeeping and accounts, power and canteen. Now we have to apportion this cost of service department to these 3 production departments. On what basis? On these information. Okay, on the basis of these information. Here you are given the horsepower of machine. Department A is 300, B 300, C is 200. So where we can relate this horsepower? Horsepower can be related with the power. Okay, so the service department, there is a service department called power department, and their expense is 1,60,000. That is basically for these 3 departments. So on what basis we can apportion this 1,60,000? We can apportion it on the basis of 3:3:2, because department A, the horsepower requirement is 300, B 300 and C is 200. So we can make it as a ratio 3:3:2. Next, you have number of workers 20, 15, 15 for department A, department B, department C. So where we can make use of this information? Timekeeping department, timekeeping and accounts, their expense is 3,00,000. This is mainly for 3 production departments. It can be linked with the number of workers. Not only that, canteen, it is 1,00,000. Okay, it's basically for the people in the respective departments, 20, 15, 15. So these 2 items can be apportioned on this basis. That is, if you are going to convert this as a ratio, probably we can say 4:3:3. That is 20:15:15. That can be converted as 4:3:3. Then we have value of stores requisition 2,50,000, 1,50,000, 1,00,000. And that can be related with the stores. Stores amount is 4,00,000. So that can be apportioned in this ratio 25:15:10, which can be further reduced. Okay, so let's have that now. Secondary overhead distribution statement. Here in this column, we'll be capturing the items of cost as per primary distribution summary. And second column is for deciding on what basis we have to apportion. Third column is for the total. Then comes the apportionment. It's basically apportioning over 3 production departments ABC. First, let's capture the cost information available as per primary distribution summary. Cost as per primary distribution summary, as available in the question, production A 30,00,000, B 26,00,000, C 24,00,000, totally it is 80,00,000. Now let's take the respective service departments, but we'll go item by item. To start with, we'll take the stores. This stores 4,00,000 have to be apportioned over 3 departments on the basis of this ratio, that is 25:5:10 or 5:3:2. That is going to be the ratio. So look at here, stores expense will be apportioned in the ratio of 5:3:2. The basis of apportionment is value of stores requisition, and what is the amount? 4,00,000, right? So in the total column we'll write 4,00,000. 4,00,000 is for 10. What is for 5:3:2? You get 2,00,000, 1,20,000 and 80,000. How I got that? 4,00,000 divided by 10, multiplied by 5, multiplied by 3, multiplied by 2. Then second item is timekeeping and accounts. Timekeeping and accounts will be apportioned on the basis of number of workers. So here we write item C, timekeeping and accounts. And what is the ratio? That is 20 is to 15 is to 15, which can be further reduced as 4 is to 3 is to 3. So that is the ratio you see here. The basis of apportionment is number of workers and total amount is 3 lakh. So let's do that now. 3 lakh divided by 10 multiplied by 4, you get 1 lakh 20. 3 lakh divided by 10 multiplied by 3 is 90,000 and 90,000. Okay, that's about timekeeping and accounts. What is the next item we have? Power, 1,60,000, that got to be apportioned on the basis of horsepower, which is 3:3:2. So let's put that here. Power ratio is 3:3:2. Basis of apportionment is horsepower. Total is 1,60,000. So 1,60,000 divided by 8 multiplied by 3. You get 60,000. Same 60,000 divided by 8 multiplied by 2, you get 40,000. In this way, we have apportioned the power cost. Next, canteen 1 lakh. So this can be apportioned on the basis of number of workers. So the ratio is going to be 4:3:3. So here we have canteen ratio is 4:3:3. Basis of apportionment is number of workers. Total amount is 1 lakh. So 1 lakh divided by 10 multiplied by 4:3:3. You get 40,000, 30,000, 30,000. And let's total this now. If you total this total column, it's going to be 89,60,000. Production department A, 34,20,000. Production department B, 29 lakh. Production department C, 26,40,000.